بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي All praises and glory are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our sustainable provider and nourisher and the soul of her life inshallah ta'ala May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala place our effort for gathering in this masjid at this mubarak time For us to study the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah ta'ala on tonight's halqa, it will be the 20th halqa. The 20th halqa so far, alhamdulillah ta'ala, and the dars will be inshallah ta'ala the 18th dars of this inshallah ta'ala, particular regular halqa that we do every Saturday inshallah ta'ala. At the kitab 40 hadithin, kulla hadithin fi khamsati khisalin. It is a 40 hadith that we study in. And each hadith has five categories. Each hadith has five characteristics, alhamdulillah. And the hadith, most of them are very knowledgeable. They are combination of jurisprudence, seerah, and fiqh, and many other hadith, inshallah ta'ala. Each night we take hadith or two for half an hour, 25 minutes to 30 minutes. Inshallah, the title of the hadith tonight, it's Ma Yudkhilul Abdul Jannah. The things that the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does it and make it easy for him to get to Jannah. The things that leads the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in terms of amal, in terms of deeds for him to go to Jannah or that gives him the inheritance of the Jannah. And salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, this hadith narrated by Abi Salama radiyallahu anhu عن مولى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذي الصحابي نريتس أحاديث عن مولى رسول الله one of the صحابي ذات صلوات الله وسلام عليه set him free in his lifetime and he said أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله said بخن بخن لخمس the word بخن in Arabic is like shouting with joy An amazement, like someone uploading someone with joy, like telling someone congratulations, or telling someone like uploading or enjoyment, like uplifting the moral of the person to cheer someone up. That the word the bakhin they use in Arabic language. And Salawatullah, he used that word bakhin bakhin means that a good news for such a person. Man laqiya Allah mustaqinan. من لقي الله مستيقنا بهن دخل الجنة five things or five issues if the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dies and he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مستيقنا believing firmly believing these things firmly believing it by the heart with certainty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he says دخل الجنة. This person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will make his house in the Jannah. This person, eternal life will be the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you die and meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing firmly these five characteristics that the hadith will mention, inshaAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you the people of the Ahlul Jannah. فريق في الجنة وفريق في السعير As you and I know, the people in the day of the Qiyamah, there will be only two part of the people. فريق في الجنة وفريق في السعير The people that go to Jannah and the people that would go to Jahannam. نعوذ بالله من ذلك. Then this hadith will tell you and explains to you the steps that will lead you for you to the people of the Ahlul Jannah. Then salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says the first point is that man laqiya Allah, whoever meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means after the day of the qiyamah, after the death, yu'minu billahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first one. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believing with firm belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min sifatihi wa asma'ihi wa dhatihi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His names and his attributes. All of that, believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of this world and the hereafter. The creator of all the creation, the owner of everything, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mustayqinan, Arabic means that word, firm belief, with no doubt at all, subhanallah. With full conviction of that, subhanallah. Certitude. If you believe that and you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's the number one. وَلْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ And the last day. And the last day. يَوْمَ الْآخِرِ is the last day in Arabic. But it's the day of the Qiyamah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring all His creations, gather them together, and where that place is taken, the judgment and the hisab. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, salawatullahi wa salam alayhi, says, this person believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing the day of the Qiyamah with the Akhirah, keep in mind that when the person believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if he does these five attributes and the characteristics of the hadith, some of the believers, they do more than believing and they add amal on it, subhanallah. Believing in the hurt and doing amal, salah, sadaqah, hajj, umrah, zakah, a'malul khair, all the good deeds you do, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might grant you to go to Jannah without hisab, without even being taken to account, without being judged, without being questioned, subhanallah. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi mentioned in hadith, he said, 70,000 of my ummah will go to Jannah without being asked a single question. Subhanallah Azza wa Jalla. Ahad al-Sahaba, he stood up and he said, Ya Rasulullah, ud'u Allah li an akuna mithlahum. Oh Rasulullah, pray for me though I can be one of these 70,000 people. And salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he says, fa anta minhum, you are one of them, subhanallah. What a great news for someone that in front of Rasulullah, being told that you are one of the people of the Ahlul Jannah, subhanallah Azza wa Jalla. And you will go to Jannah without being asked any question. Then, some of the people, they believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they believe the day of the Qiyamah and the judgment, and they believe all the arkans of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they fall short of amal that can guarantee them into Jannah, subhanallah. Can guarantee them. Or maybe some other scenario, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Yawm al-Qiyamah, Rasulullah, and everything else they believe it. And they are Muslim, and they have that kind of believing. But they committed sins that so huge. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive them with His mercy, it has to be taken to a punishment. Then even if they go for a punishment, they will not be settling in the Jahannam or not forever. Subhanallah. Keep in mind that they are coming out after being cleaned for the sin that they committed, and eventually they will settle into the Jannah, subhanallah. That's how the ahadith and the ulama explain that. The third point is that the person has to believe وَبِالْ جَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. The third point, يُؤْمِنُ بِالْجَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ. He has to believe Jannah, paradise, and nar, which is the hellfire, exists and is truth and is haq, subhanallah. If someone denies that Jannah does not exist and nar does not exist and says that this is hypothetical, it is not reality, his iman is not complete, subhanallah. His iman is not complete. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned in the Quran, Jannah and Jahannam, it is one of the things that the person as a mu'min, as a Muslim, he has to believe it, that Jannah and Nar exist, subhanallah. The fourth point, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he says, وَالْبَعْثُ The day of the resurrection, subhanallah. The most of the mushrikeen and those polytheism at the time of Rasulullah, the question they had more often was that, are we going to be resurrected after we die, subhanallah? That was the question they used to keep on asking, subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after we die and we become dust, will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will He bring life back to us, life, and take us into account? That what they used to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِذَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ That's the question they ask in the Quran. They say, if we die and our bones and flesh become like a dust, will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect us? Of course Allah can do that, because Allah found you from nothing. Why you've been existed before that? No. Allah found you from nothing, subhanallah. هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. There was a time on the planet Earth and the world, the human or humanity was not something to mention at all, subhanallah. Earth and heaven existed, there was no single human being that walked on the planet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was there, the malaika was there, but there was no single human being. حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ. There was a portion, a duration of a time, the humanity was not even something to mention. Then Allah found them and create them. Then if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you die and you become a dust, the same Allah will form you again, will resurrect you from the grave, and He will take you into accountable for the sins that you have committed. That what the hadith are teaching us. Though the person has to believe wal ba'th, the day of the resurrection, subhanallah azza wa jalla. The mu'min of the Muslim has to believe. If the person denies any of this four, the ulama says his iman is not complete and his submission to Allah as a Muslim is a questionable. Is questionable because it's a halfway down, halfway through, not full. Then salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi mentioned the last point. Al-Hisab, subhanallah, azza wa jal. A judgment, al-Hisab, the day of the Qiyamah, when people gather together, subhanallah, in that platform, in the day of the Qiyamah, what are they going to do? Are they just being there as a parade? Dancing, singing all around place? Having picnic or whatever? No, subhanallah, it is Hisab, subhanallah. It is Yawm al-Hisab. I would like to have, if anyone interested to have a copy of this, inshallah ta'ala, you can share, inshallah, so we can study together, inshallah ta'ala. Then there will be a hisab, subhanallah, azza wa jal. There will be a hisab. And salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says in hadith, in another hadith, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he says, فَمَنْ كَانَتْ لَهُ مَظْلَمَةً لِأَخِيهِ مِنْ عِرْضِهِ أَوْ شَيْئًا فَلْيَحْتَلِلْ مِنْهُ الْيَوْمَ قَبْلَ أَلَّا يَكُونَ دِينَارًا وَلَا دِرْهَمٍ. Subhanallah. Whoever has an issue with his brother, subhanallah. Whoever has an issue with his brother, in times of maybe slandering or insulting or taking his property or harming him, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says, you have to ask for forgiveness now as you're living in this world, because when you meet the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there will be no forgiveness can take place between you, subhanallah. Everything else has to be while you are alive together. Oh brother, I insulted you, please forgive me. Oh brother, I took your money, forgive me. Oh brother, I harm you in a one way, forgive me. Oh brother, I gossip you and I backbite you, forgive me. It is only happiness in this world right now. By the time we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you and I will not argue, subhanallah. It will be standing in the front of the judge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then there will be only hisab. Then salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he went to the extent, he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَتُؤَدُّنَّ الْحُقُوقَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. At the day of the Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you a reward that you have earned in the world so much and so hard, only to be given someone that you insulted, someone that you hit, someone that you done something wrong, someone that you take his money of his wealth. Allah will give him your reward to him, subhanallah. And you will become a zero because you don't have an account, you are bankrupt. Then the only way for you to face, because the Jannah need is an income. You don't have it anymore because your income has been given to somebody else that you harmed them in the world, subhanallah. Then you are bankrupt. Then the only way you're going to face it to Jahannam, subhanallah. Then salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi went to the extent and he's saying, حَتَّى يُقَادُ لِلشَّاتِ الْجَلْحَاءَ مِنْ شَاتِ الْقَرْنَاءَ. The hisab of the Qiyamah and the hisab of the day of the judgment, it is an equistant that salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi said, even the goats, the sheep and the goat that hit each other in the wall, subhanallah, subhanallah, azza wa jal. The goats and the sheep and the bulls and the animals that are hitting each other on the head as they fight,
The one that has horns and the one does not have a horns, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to that extent will judge them who is wrong and who harm who more. Subhanallah. Ash-shat al-qarna. The one with horn and the one without horn, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a judge between them. Subhanallah azza wa jalla. What about the human being then? Allah give you the intellect. Allah give you the knowledge. Allah give you the understanding. Allah give you the heart and the qalb to evaluate things. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can judge between two animals, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can say that this animal you have a horn, you hit this other animal with have no horn, then today I'll make a retribution. Then how about human being? It is nothing more to mention, subhanallah. That will be how justiful and justice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will done in the day of the Qiyam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says. Then the hisab will come. So the person has to believe this hisab. It will take place and it is inevitable, subhanallah. It has to take a hisab on the day of the Qiyamah, subhanallah. Then from hisab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will weigh you a'mal you have done in the world, the salah, the zakah, the istighfar, the hajj, and everything else that you have done, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama say, no matter how much you done khair, subhanallah, it does not buy and cannot buy a jannah, subhanallah. It cannot buy a jannah. That how valuable jannah is. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says, none of you will enter jannah because of the amal and the good deeds that he has done it. The sahaba questioned Rasulullah and they said, ya Rasulullah, even you, how about you Rasulullah? You are the Nabi of Allah subhanallah. And Rasulullah, he said, hatta ana, even I will not have enough amal that can buy me in Jannah unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants me Jannah because of his permission. Subhanallah. It is such a valuable Jannah, subhanallah azza wa jal. Then no one will be satisfied and sit back and say, alhamdulillah, I pray everything, I have paid zakat, I have paid sadaqah, no shortcomings, nothing. And have the mentality that this amal will take you to Jannah without question. There's a story that been mentioned in the kitab is that the people before us, there was someone who used to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Solitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He set up a place only to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day in, day out. Nothing else in this world, subhanallah. Then the shaitan come to him and make waswas in his mind, subhanallah. Shaitan is an evil. He convinced him that he said, you have done so much amal, subhanallah. You accumulated so much huge amal. Then this can buy you the Jannah, subhanallah, azza wa jal. That was the shaitan give him the waswas. Then eventually dies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show him how much amal he made and how important the Jannah is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the kitabs are mentioning that his eye was weighed, only his eye, one of them, was weighed in a scale plus all the amal that he has been doing so long and has been put in another way. The side of the eye overtaken the entire amal that he has been doing of a century almost, subhanallah azza wa jal. And he became a bankrupt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show him, this is the amal you have done. Only the eye I gave you for you while you live in the world, it is more valuable than the entire amal that you have been making, subhanallah. Then the reason this kind of history been narrated is that for you to have the belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessings, we earn Jannah inshaAllah. With a good commitment and believing in it. But we will not be kind of flattering all over and pushing that. I do amal inshaAllah, the Jannah will be there. That's what Rasulullah doesn't want you to do. You have to do the right thing. And you have to be humble and simple with humility. That ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Jannah all the time. Then salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. In another hadith, when the Sahaba, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, they were so eager to do some kind of khair. Then they come to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, ya Rasulullah, dhahab ahlu dhuthuri bil ujur. The people that have money, they take all the ajr. They do what we do, salah, ibadah, and everything else. They are in the masjid with us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them some extra money because they are rich and they giving this money to a charity sadaqah. They do a lot of sadaqah. So they superseded us. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says, أَفَلَا أُعَلِّمُكُمْ شَيْئًا Shouldn't I teach you something? تَدْرُكُونَ مَنْ سَبَقَكُمْ وَتَسْبِقُونَ بِهِ مَنْ بَعْدَكُمْ Shouldn't I show you something that you can catch up those who are ahead of you in terms of reward, in terms of amal? Shouldn't I show you something that the people behind you cannot even catch you up? And they said, قَالُوا بَلَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ Ya رَسُولُ اللَّهِ tell us. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he says, تُسَبِّحُونَ وَتُحَمِّدُونَ وَتُكَبِّرُونَ ثَلَاثًا وَثَلَاثِينَ بَعْدَ كُلَّ دُبُرِ صَلَاتٍ You will have to do 33 times Subhanallah after Salah, 33 times Walhamdulillah, 33 times Wallahu Akbar in every Salah, Subhanallah. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says, that will make you reach the people that are ahead of you, Subhanallah. Ahibati, think, imagine today. Assalamu alaikum, the Imam. Everyone said the Yad, Subhanallah, Azza wa Jalla. Fa'ayna tasbih, Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. The other ahadith mentioned that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will give you 100 tawab, and Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will erase 100 minor sins from your kitab, Subhanallah. This tasbih are there for a reason, Subhanallah. Mu'ad ibn Jabal, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give him a life, he says, do not leave to do that. Then this tasbih, they are not there for nothing. They are there for you and I to be guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our own protection, our own reward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time you make a salah, salamu alaykum, you have to do subhanallah 33 times, walhamdulillah 33 times, wallahu akbar 33 times, and the last one, la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulku wa lahul hamdu ala kulli shayin qadir. Then it becomes 100, subhanallah. Imagine doing that 5 times a day, subhanallah. The link that you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with him is going to be so solid, so strong and so tough. You have a good link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it will give you the humility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that remembers him all the time. Then what happened is that the same sahaba come to Rasulullah and they said, Ya Rasulullah, our brothers, the one we mentioned before, they doing the same thing that you tell us to do, subhanallah. They doing the same thing that you tell us to do. The salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi says, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ That is the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he gives to whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants it. Because the other sahaba, despite them having money, they also doing the same khair that Rasulullah tell them these guys to do. And the Rasulullah, he said, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ It is the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he can give to whoever of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he wanted. The hadith of tonight, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, is mentioning, it is very important. It is something that you and I need all the way to reflect and see where we can weigh our life. The hadith of Rasulullah, it is like a mirror. Everyone, when we go into work in the morning, what's the last thing we do? We have to go to the mirror, make sure that my hair is well combed, my face is so-so, my clothes and everything are fine. The ahadith of Rasulullah are you a mirror for you to weigh your character, your personality, your standard of living, your iman and your amal, subhanallah, azza wa jalla. For without you knowing or not even giving intention to it, you will have so many defects in your life, akhi. And that's why it's very important, even once a week, let's come together. Study hadith of two. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned another hadith. He said, bakhin bakhin, with the same word, or hooray, or, you know, cheers for the people. He was giving kind of a good news. He says, ma athqalahunna fil mizan, what is more heavier in the scale of the qiyamah, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the word la ilaha illallah. Wallahu Akbar, Subhanallah, Walhamdulillah. He said, those are the heaviest someone can come in the day of the Qiyamah in times of Ajr. Subhanallah, Azza wa Jalla. Nothing is more heavier than those words, Subhanallah, Azza wa Jalla. The hadith mentioned in the last part, he said, وَوَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ يُتَوَفَّى فَيَحْتَسِبُهُ وَالِدَيْهِ and a good child, good God-fearing child that passes away and dies it, and his parents are making shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make it patient and sabr, subhanallah. Allah will give them such a huge reward that they will be satisfied in the day of the Qiyamah, subhanallah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes your child, Allah is not going to leave you empty-handed, subhanallah, azza wa jalla. All you need to say is that, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Inna lillahi ma a'ta wa lahu ma akhad wa kullu shay'in 'indahu bi miqdar. For you to say such a small word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of the Qiyamah will give you a reward that you cannot even mention it, subhanallah. So heavy according to the hadith of Rasulullah. So the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our life. As much as we need food to exist and live healthier, our soul needs the same food. What's the food of the soul? The food we eat for the body. How about the soul? If we do not make the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we do not study the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we do not read the Quran, if we do not entertain ourselves with the ahadith of Rasulullah, if we do not do the mudhakir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the soul will be starved to death, starvation. If we do not eat food, what will happen? We become weak physically and eventually become sick, or maybe we'll die. The soul of human being, if it does not have the dhikr of Allah, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by it is all forms and kinds, whether to study, whether to read, whether to make tadabbur, whether to do as someone passing the message to other people. Unless you involve all some kind of stuff of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your soul will die, subhanallah azza wa jal. Only the body will walk. The morality and mentality and the soul will be starving because there's no deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned, he said, Kalla balrana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. For those who keep on committing sins without remembering Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put locks on them in the heart. No khair comes out, subhanallah. No khair goes in their heart. And no khair comes out, subhanallah, azza wa jalla. Imagine if such a person meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's nothing to mention. Inshallah ta'ala, the hadith of tonight, I'm going to read one more time. An Abi Salama radiallahu anhu, this sahabi, an Mawla Rasulullah, says, an Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah said, baqin, good news, li khamsin, five things, man laqiya allaha mustayqinan, whoever meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mustayqinan bihinna, believing with certainty and firm with conviction, دخل الجنة, subhanallah. The word دخل is like a past in English. دخل. It almost like he has gone to Jannah. It's a guarantee. Inshallah ta'ala. يؤمن بالله. He believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من صفاته. The description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And his attributes. وأسمائه. The name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وذاته. Akhi, to learn the sifat of Allah, the asma of Allah, and all of that. What you need, it is to sit together and learn together. Unless we learn together, we will not know the sifat of Allah, the asma of Allah. With that, we will not even know that. Then the person has to believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal yawmil akhir, and the last day, and he has to believe bil jannati wal nar. Nar and jannah exists, and is reality, and is truth. والبعث and the day of the resurrection, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make everyone to come out from their graves, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take them in the judgment. والحساب and the accountability of the qiyamah, subhanallah. The accountability of the qiyamah. ما من human being, no creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the hisab, that means small or big. Nothing will be left, subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give everyone to his book from the dunya. Khair, evil, and good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, the people who commit a lot of sins, a lot of them, they will say, مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابَ لَا يُقَادِرُ سَقِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْسَاهَا. What is this book? What is this kind of account? There's nothing left, big, minor or major, everything is in that kitab. Subhanallah, they kind of are shocked to see that. Subhanallah, Azza wa Jalla. They kind of shocked to see that. Every kalima, subhanallah, every word that comes from your mind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has assigned specific angels that are always with you to write it down, subhanallah. Specific angels. Every single word, no matter what it is, they just keep writing, subhanallah, Azza wa Jalla. Kitaban, kiraman, katibin. Kiraman, katibin, subhanallah. They keep on writing. Whatever khair you say, they write it. Whatever bad you say, they write it. Whatever good you say, they write it. Whatever evil you say, they write it, subhanallah, Azza wa Jalla. Then, akhibati, inshallah ta'ala, we will try our best, inshallah ta'ala, to come together, gather together for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, learn together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guarantee us what we wanted in this dunya and the hereafter. Remember that Bukhari, rahimahullah, the most read book after Sunnah, after the Kitab Allah, Al-Quran, and after Hadith Rasulullah, Bukhari, Imam Bukhari. He and two other students were the only three people in his city that aligned in the Hadith of Rasulullah at his time. And today, millions of Muslims are making and reading his own Kitab, subhanallah. Then the objective is not too far. All we need is to have niyyah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Allahumma barik lana wa sallamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.